Okay, Camp Rock, which means Jonas Brothers, which is awkward.
Hey, I'm Hailee Steinfeld, and I've got this wonderful box on my lap because I am going to be delving back into my teenage self. I really love this box. What was your most awkward teenage dating moment? This is, okay, so there was this sweet, sweet boy. He was a friend, like we were friends. Well, I thought, well, yeah, we were friends. And by the way, again, still going through this in my life today, right? But I just remember one day he brought a dozen roses to school for me, and I was so incredibly embarrassed because, like, you know, look, you can't be, I mean, like, what are you gonna do? I'm like, I don't like you, but love the flowers. But like, I don't want you to think, you know, I can't accept these. Oh, but I mean, the inner monologue was like going crazy, but I just felt so bad. I still have this image of, I'm not gonna say his name because that's gonna haunt me. What was your nickname when you were growing up? Hales comes out of Hailee, which, I mean, I don't hate, I don't love it. Hayes sort of formed in the last couple years of my life between some friends and my fans, which I like a lot more. So, Jeff Bridges called me Hay forever. Which, I mean, look, he can call me anything he wants. What was your most used teenage slang? I think now my most used teenage slang would probably be dope. I say dope a lot about everything. Or like, it's a vibe, which I hate, but I still say it. I kind of feel like it's that thing you say when something's not really great. You're like, it's a vibe. Okay, what single piece of advice would you give your teenage self? Wow, I'm about to get real, hang on. As hard as this sounds and as much easier as it is said than done, there is so much importance in being true to yourself. I think it's so easy to get caught up in society standards, in people in your life's standards, or just, you know, want to conform to certain behaviors that's not really true to you, just to maybe be liked by a single person or have, you know, a handful of positive comments on some kind of photo. I don't know. I just think stay true to who you are. And as long as you're doing, at the end of the day, what makes you feel good about you, then it can never be the wrong thing. But don't do it for anybody else. Do it for you. Yeah. Hey, yeah, bring on the slow clap, okay? What was the most embarrassing trend you took part in? Peace signs, but like the actual peace signs. I mean, I had necklaces and socks and, but would wear everything at the same time, t-shirts. It was a phase. We'll leave it there. A photo popped into my brain. I don't want to relish in this moment any longer. What was your signature scent? Ooh. I do think the first perfume that I like fell in love with was Prada. I think it was called Candy something? Maybe not. I'm making that up. Skirt, cut this from the video. What TV show were you obsessed with? Ooh, okay. So. I don't even know where to begin. Even Stevens, That's So Raven, Lizzie McGuire, okay. I mean, Hannah Montana, duh. Camp Rock, whoa. That was a thing for a moment. Okay. I saw Camp Rock, right? I mean, the obsession was so real. I was so obsessed with Demi in that movie, okay? Everything about her, her hair, the way she dressed, everything. I took a photo of Demi Lovato into a hair salon. And I said, I wanna look like Demi. Cut me some bangs, just like this. And I didn't realize until the next day when I, you know, washed my hair and tried to do my bangs on my own, that I don't have Demi's hair. And it did not look the same. And I then spent too much time trying to grow those things out. Yeah, Demi knows that because my mom told her. Who was your celebrity crush as a teenager and have you met them since? That's funny. I crushed on too many people. I never had one. I was just gonna say, I never really went through like the poster on the wall phase, but that's such a lie.
This is like a tell-all. This is not okay. Camp Rock, which means Jonas Brothers, which is awkward, but no, it's okay. I bought one magazine and got excited and they had all the posters in there, and I just like put them up and I taped them up in my closet, and then I got sick of it real fast, you know? I didn't, they were there for a while. What was the subject you were worst at school? You know what's funny? I really enjoyed every subject when I understood it. When I didn't understand it, I hated it, and I was not good at it because I didn't know what was going on. But I had some really great teachers that made that made learning fun. But the subject I was worst at, probably, it might have been math, because once you missed one piece of information, you're done and you're screwed. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, if there was 1 second I was daydreaming about Camp Rock, what? I would just, you know, lose the part of the instruction, and I would then not know everything that came after that. What was the most embarrassing thing a parent caught you doing? They never like caught me singing into a hairbrush. That was just a normal occurrence. Probably just talking to myself. But parents know everything. What would your 16-year-old self say to you now? What are you thinking? Why? When? How? What? I don't even know what to say to you now. I don't think I realized quite yet at that point, or at least nowhere near as much as I do now, how hard that I would have to work. So maybe my 16-year-old self would just say that they're proud. I'm proud. How do I speak about this? Where was your first kiss? Ooh, it was. Oh God, I just realized. Wow. All right, Hailee, get it together. Okay, so we were like sitting on the couch, talking, chatting, whatever. It was time for him to go home, so I was walking him out, and it was like, you know, the tension had been building the entire night. And I definitely was like, he's gonna have to kiss me or else I'm out. Which is like bold, and I still think that way, which is like, gets me into trouble. Anyway, he kissed me. It was right by the front door, which I learned was such a bummer after I decided I didn't like him, because then every time I walked through my front door, I had to think of him. But all I remember about that first kiss was that he kissed me once and I told him it was bad. So then he kissed me again. But the second time was better, so I guess it all worked out in the end. Ooh, what song describes your teens? I went through like a classic rock, Fleetwood Mac, the Eagles, and then I kind of got into like later teens, maybe some Boys to Men, you know what I'm saying? It's taken some turns, you know, but like all swiftly, you know? So thank God that's over. That was me playing my teenage self. Please check out my new show, Dickinson, on November 1st on Apple TV+.